Good morning, Wanda Faye here. It is 8:20 a.m. Pacific time on this Thursday, August 9th, 2018. Hope you're doing well out there. Just wanted to go over a few headlines in the news today. And I came over here to my news app. I use one of my sources. I use Smart News. It's a Smart News app. You can get it on the Google Play. So I was just going to go over a few headlines to just do something different today, but come over here and I see this: Willow Creek church leaders quit over sexual misconduct scandal. You can read that at BBC News. I'll just read a little bit. It's the leaders at one of the biggest mega churches in the U.S. have quit over a sexual misconduct scandal that has already claimed its founder. A statement from elders at the Willow Creek Church said a new start was needed and that they should have handled the allegations better. Bill Hybels stepped down earlier this year after accusations of inappropriate conduct emerged. He has denied the allegations, but said he had become a distraction. So you can read this over at the BBC News. I'm sure there's other news articles about that probably by now. Anyway, what I was thinking about earlier is that, you know, as soon as we all realize we're all just hypocrites, basically. And I'm not accusing you of being a hypocrite. I'm accusing myself of being a hypocrite because it seems like I can't, like, be perfect like Jesus. So when I fail, it's like the old guilt complex comes in, and you know, oh, look at you, you know, you're talking about Jesus and, you know, reading his word and praying, and you've got news and prayer and blah blah blah, you know. And so really, when we all realize that we can never attain to the perfection of Jesus Christ, we're better off. If we, I'm not saying don't try to keep trying, you know, but you know, we're all pretty much, and I start with me, you know, we're guilty of being hypocrites. And I think that's what keeps a lot of people out of coming to Jesus, is because they look at us, they look at the church, and they see hypocrisy, which I did before I came to Jesus. Before I came to Jesus, I saw hypocrisy in the church, and I'm going, well, why would I want to be a part of that? But it's neat, because when I came to Jesus, I wasn't coming to a church. I went to a church later, of course, soon after. I mean, I came to Jesus in a church. Don't get me wrong, in a church, but I came to Jesus. So there's a difference. The problem we have is that we, after we come to Jesus, we immediately start getting, you know, we get fed the Word of God, and we love the Word of God, and we love God, and then we get into this religiousness, you know, religion, and we all come together at a church somewhere, and blah blah blah, you know. I'm not making light of it, I'm not mocking it at all, but you know, remember, you know, people say, you know, you've fallen from grace. You know, no, it's when people fall from grace, they accuse people when they sin, you know, after they've been saved and stuff, they've fallen from grace. It's like, no, you fall from grace when you get off of Jesus Christ onto religion and read the book of Galatians. It will help you. It's just six short chapters. Read it often. I say read it often. Don't try to, you know, pick it apart if you can and study it, that's fine and great and stuff, but at least if you don't do anything else but just read it through, stay in the Gospels, the four Gospels, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. I would say stay in, you know, read the Psalms and the Proverbs for wisdom, and just try to give each other grace and forgive each other. But we set the standard so high that people on the outside, that's why Jesus said, you know, Jesus said, the basically he said the prostitutes, you know, would get into the kingdom of God before the self-righteous, you know, the self-righteous, the Sadducees and the Pharisees in the Jewish religion, when he was speaking to them about them. And so I'm going to make this short now. I'm going to pray for us that God, you give us your grace and mercy. Forgive us. We forgive others. And help us have a great day, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen. Okay, everybody, have a great day. Bye-bye.